evening to everyone. Good evening to everyone. That's a little better. It's very rare that I stick to a program and I'm going to change right now. We want to change that, break forth, and do for you an excerpt from Giacomo Puccini's The Messa di Gloria. We want to do some excerpts from this movement, which will take about 11 minutes. And don't let the Latin throw you off. It says, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all men. So this is Puccini's Gloria.
Gloria, in excelsis Deo, gloria in excelsis Deo.
Adolphus Hale Stork is an African-American composer who has really become famous in the last decade or so. He lives in nearby Virginia Beach, Virginia. Now, this piece is a very complicated piece in which we have grown to love so quickly. Every section will sing a completely different line for you. The meaning is very polyphonic. And it's called "The God of Glory Thunders."
Thunder, the God of glory, thunder. Oh. into His excellent greatness.
Praise Him for His power and glory, and for the many years of hearing the story. From this gospel preacher and leader of the people, come now, let us praise
Him.
Can we get a little more gain on all the solo mics? I want to do for you three spirituals. You have two listening. You want to do firstly a spiritual arranged by Robert Morris. Is a light a shine in the heavens? Then I want to call out Nut Prince of Chaos. I want you to come out and do a witness for me. And then we'll end the set with Swing Down, Sweet Chariot, Stop, and three Negro spirituals.
Thank you.
still. Now ain't that a witness for my Lord? Ain't that a witness for my Lord? Ain't that a witness for my Lord? My soul is a witness for my Lord. Now there was a man of the Pharisees. His name was Nicodemus, and he didn't believe. The same came to Christ by night, wanted to be taught out of human sight. Nicodemus was a man desired to know how a man can be born when he is old. Christ told Nicodemus as a friend, man, you must be born again. Said, marvel not, man, if you want to be wise, repent, believe, and be baptized. Then you'll be a witness for my Lord. You'll be a witness for my Lord. You'll be a witness for my Lord. Saul is a witness for my Lord. You read about Samson from his birth, the strongest man that ever lived on earth. Way back yonder in ancient times, he killed 10,000 other Philistines. Then old Samson went wandering about. Samson's strength was never found out, till his wife sat upon his knees. She said, tell me where your strength lies, if you please. Now Samson's wife, she talked so bare. Samson said, cut off my hair, shake my head, just as clean as your hand, and my strength will come like a natural man. Oh, Samson was a witness for my Lord. Samson was a witness for my Lord. Samson was a witness for my Lord. Saul is a witness for my Lord. That's not a witness. Now that's not a witness. That's not a witness. My soul is a witness for my Lord. That's not a witness.
Well, there. Turning wind. the shadows may hang o'er the way, and sorrows they do come to beckon us home. Our precious
These next two items will be two medleys. The first one was first done at my recital at Morgan State University. And it was at that recital that my now aunt Princess gave me that invitation to come here. That was 3 years ago, and my schedule could never allow me to come. So we want to do this for you now, and you hear four soloists. Let's, Heather, you start for me, then you'll hear the voice of Theron Thomas, then the voice of Janelle McCracken, and Eric Sumter will finish it out. And then we go to another medley those of us who are a little bit older than I am, you'll recognize a lot of these songs. So you do for me now the Jesus medley and the Andrew Crouch medley.
Thank you. Such honor and such love. hear their name. Something happens to me when I hear their name. Cause I know that there's power in that name, and healing in that name. I know that the devil has to flee when he hears that precious name.
Lord,
I want to know more.
Lord,
start winding down. Now, having friends is a wonderful thing. We just came back from a 14-day spring tour. A spring tour which took us to Nashville, Tennessee, to Oakwood College, to Atlanta, Georgia, Savannah, Georgia, and then Orlando, Florida. We had a great, great time. And always traveling with us, let me introduce, and she hates when I say this, she's really my direct boss. And that's the lady on the piano, Mrs. Tony Hall. Mrs. Hall, can you take it for her? before we sing our last song, and before we came on stage, I was trying to explain to the choir what Caribbean Union College meant to me. I basically grew up on campus, saw so many people come and so many people go. And I would have never thought I would end up at Pine Forge Academy, but even at Pine Forge Academy, there's a strong CUC connection as well. And some of you may remember Overly Fleming. She's a chief accountant. And of course, we have Dean Jones. Where's Dean Jones? And Pine Forge kind of reminds me of CUC in a way, a campus setting, Friday night vespers, choir, and all of that. And the past already, I was just about to introduce him. When I left CUC, I went to Oakwood College, where Mr. Mallory took me under his wings. And he really did a tremendous job being one of my inspirations. This is my third year at Pine Forge Academy, and I could honestly say that the choir this year, my first year, I think we did my first concert here with Pine Forge. And that year, I didn't think I could top it the next year, and we got better then. But this choir, I just told Ms. Hutton, since January, I've been in glee. The kids sound great, and they work oh so hard. They put up with all my crazy antics. And we've had some friends who helped us out greatly, Mr. Mallory, who came in and did some workshops with us. So we are so grateful. I think the song was sung this morning. And that's okay. Because every time you hear it, it's a totally new expression. And I think I gave you part of the story on last year. At CUC, Friday nights for me was a special time. You went to Vespers, and sometimes I'd have band rehearsal with Mr. Roach over here, the trumpet section, and I may have a choir rehearsal and a group practice. And it was the norm for me to get home at 11 p.m., midnight, 1. I mean, that was a normal thing. But no matter what time I got home, there was a tape that my father had that I had to play before I went to sleep. If I was too tired, I'd play this one song. I'd fast forward and find it. And this song always did something for me. And every time we sing it, I always like to repeat these words so that it wouldn't go over your heads when we sing. In the words of Charles Tindley, he says, "Beams of heaven as I go through this wilderness here below, guide my feet in peaceful ways and turn my midnights into days. When in the darkness I grope, faith always sees a star of hope. And soon from all life's grief and life's danger, I shall be free someday." Tinley goes on, and a verse that speaks to me all the time. He says, "Burdens now may crush me down." Anyone have a burden today? "Disappointments are all around. Trouble speaks in a mournful sigh, and we show our sorrow through a tear-stained eye." And I'm skipping to that part that says, "But there is a God who rules above. He has a hand of power, but a heart of love. If I am right, he'll fight my battles. Yes. I shall be free someday." Before I go into the refrain, I mean, I'll be able to go home tonight if I don't do this. I mentioned that walk I took here back in July. And this year has been a good year, not just because of choir, because of Coretta Samuel, now Ferdinand. Can we stand? This is my wife. Tinley says, I do not know how long 'twill be, nor what the future holds for me. But this I know, that if Jesus leads me, I shall get home someday. Janelle, I want you to sing this for me, Destiny, and Jessica T, you come up. And today, Kay and I spent the entire day with four seniors. The senior class this year, I'll miss so much. When I came to Pine Forge, they're my little babies, my originals. Where are the seniors? You stand and take, let them clap for you. Seniors, y'all stand up. You leave in 6 weeks. Last voice you'll hear, the solo voice, a unique voice, voice of Shari Miles. And can we get all these solo mics like to the same level?